It's that time of the year again. Monsoons are here. While it's a breather from the scorching heat, monsoon showers also bring with them a host of problems, especially for the big metros. The most difficult of them is the menace of dengue. This is the reason why NDTV and DHFL Pramerica's campaign, Behtar India, has made fighting dengue as its main cause. Over the next half an hour, we'll take you across different parts of the country and show you how schools, students and city corporations are working hard towards fighting this menace. But first up, a campaign from Gurugram that proves that awareness can be the first big step towards combating dengue. The campaign, very aptly named Hum versus Dengue.
Hum versus Dengue is back. A community initiative that was lauded for its contribution in fighting the menace of dengue in Gurugram last year. This year's agenda is large-scale awareness workshops, blood donation drives, and a special focus on students to supplement the efforts of Gurugram's health department in fighting dengue. Why Gurugram? Because Haryana's financial epicenter's rapid development makes it more susceptible to vector-borne diseases.
When it comes to fighting dengue, we have a problem where it's a growing city, so lots of construction going on, lots of digging happening in the city. There are lots of industries around, so lots of habitations for labor are there, and it's predominantly an urban disease. So as a city, we have to prepare for this monsoon season, and I believe with the help of lots of community involvement, will be able to lessen the burden of disease this time.
With private school students as its volunteers, Hum versus Dengue is reaching out to government school students to equip them with the right information on the disease.
Hum versus Dengue, iska pata mereko apni best friend se pata chala jab Riya ne ye school mein introduce kiya. Hum sab log logon ke ghar gaye aur unse humne pucha ki kya aap interested ho ye kaam karne mein. To kuch logon ne kaha ha aur kuch ne kaha nahi.
The initiative is supported by DHFL Pramerica Life Insurance. Along with the other efforts, it's also extending financial help for protection of these children against dengue.
The moment you can reach the corporate, you can convince them that we are part of this entire campaign. You know, it is not only the companies which step in, it is also the families of those corporate people who come in. And when the families come in, then the schools follow. So it's a chain which is there. And personally, we are corporates later, we are citizens first.
For Gurugram's health department and corporation, such help from a corporate side has made a huge difference.
To prevent dengue and malaria, it is basically awareness, communication, awareness in the public, awareness in the schools. So awareness is the most important aspect which Hum and Dengue they are helping.
So instead of putting the responsibility on corporations, let us all join hands and put in an effort, because together we will defeat dengue.
In Behtar India's drive towards dengue, our children hold the most important place. After all, no one can beat their will and their energy to work for a change. And this reflects in the dengue fighting strategy of Municipal of Delhi and Gurugram as well.
Good afternoon, bachcho. मेरा नाम राजेश है मैं नगर निगम गुड़गांव से हूँ जैसा कि आप लोगों को पता है कि डेंगू का सीजन स्टार्ट हो गया है
दिस इज हाउ द म्युनिसिपल कॉर्पोरेशन ऑफ गुरुग्राम इज ट्राइंग टू डिफीट डेंगू बाय मेकिंग द स्टूडेंट्स एट दिस गवर्नमेंट स्कूल इन गुरुग्राम अवेयर अबाउट प्रिवेंटिव मेजर्स
एडिस इजिप्टी नाम के एक मच्छर के काटने के द्वारा यह संक्रमित रोग डेंगू रोग लगता है
Overcrowding and poor cleaning systems around their homes makes underprivileged children more susceptible to dengue, and arming them with effective solutions reduces the risk of dengue for their entire family.
उच्च तापमान में एक फीवर होता है 103 से 104 तो हमें फीवर को कम करने के लिए पैरासिटामोल लेनी चाहिए लेकिन इसके अलावा कोई दवाई नहीं लेनी चाहिए और अगर किसी को डेंगू हुआ है तो उसे ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा द्रव चीज़ें यूज़ करनी चाहिए जैसे पानी नारियल पानी और इस प्रकार के फ्रूट्स खाने चाहिए जिनमें पानी की अधिकतम मात्रा होती है
इन लोगों को अंदर इस चीज़ को लेकर जागरूकता आएगी ये अपने आसपास के लोगों को भी समझाएंगे उसकी ब्रीडिंग होने से रोकेंगे आजकल जैसे जो लोग हैं कुछ भी दवाइयाँ खा लेते हैं वो चीज़ इनको बहुत ज़्यादा इफेक्ट करेगी अवेयर करेगी
इनिशिएटिव्स लाइक दीज ऑन पार्ट ऑफ द एमसीजी also encouraged government schools to keep their own efforts on to fight dengue.
हम एक तो स्कूल में कहीं पानी वानी इकट्ठा नहीं होने देते कहीं भी क्योंकि बारिश का सीजन है तो पानी आ जाए तो कोशिश होती है उसको निकलवाएं और बाकी बच्चों को अवेयर करते हैं बच्चों को बताते हैं कि बेटे ये पानी कहीं ऐसे खड़ा नहीं होना चाहिए बिकॉज मच्छर उसी पे पनपता है
NDTV and DHFL Pramerica's campaign Behtar India aims to fight the scourge of dengue by tapping into the energy of these young change makers. Behtar India, along with the Municipal Corporation of Delhi, is trying to reach out to schools across the capital to equip students with more and more information to fight dengue.
The awareness that the children can create cannot be created by adults because they make all the difference to the society because they are the young citizens who are the future of the country. So I think they can help us out, they can tell their parents, their society people about preserving and keeping things neat, clean, not let the water get collected in the society.
We try to change the mindset of everyone in our school so that they can change the mindset of their parents, their family members and their neighbors. Once we all are well aware that dengue is dangerous and how we can prevent dengue, we will automatically stop it and we will try to prevent it.
These young crusaders are taking forward the mission to make a Behtar India. This is what the Municipal Corporation of Delhi is preparing to fight. The larvae of Aedes aegypti mosquitoes. Creating awareness about dengue can be the biggest tool to fight it. With this as a strategy, MCD is training the paramedical staff at Delhi hospitals.
मच्छर हैं जो कि म्यूनिसिपल कॉरपोरेशन कंट्रोल करने का काम कर रहा है डिजीज को कंट्रोल करना है तो मॉस्किटो को कंट्रोल करना है
लास्ट ईयर द नेशनल कैपिटल रीजन सॉ वन ऑफ द वर्स्ट आउटब्रेक्स ऑफ डेंगू एंड चिकनगुनिया इन मेनी इयर्स द की टू प्रिवेंट सच एन आउटब्रेक इज टू नॉट लेट मॉस्किटोज ब्रीड बट इज इट ओनली अप टू द म्यूनिसिपल कॉरपोरेशन टू डू दैट
इसमें पब्लिक अवेयरनेस जो है वो बहुत जरूरी है क्योंकि डेंगू मॉस्किटो घरों के अंदर पैदा होता है डोमेस्टिक ब्रीडर है और घरों में हौदी टंकी कूलर अंडरग्राउंड टैंक ओवरहेड टैंक बर्ड स्पॉट इन सब के अंदर ब्रीड करता है
Behtar India has made fighting the scourge of mosquito borne diseases as its main focus and we believe it's our children who can help achieve that Behtar India, along with the Municipal Corporation of Delhi, is reaching out to school students to sensitize them about their role in this big fight against dengue.
Students are important messengers. They are part of the community. They can send messages to the neighborhood, community at large, shopkeepers, to smaller institutions. Around in and around the house and the school.
These campaigns contribute a lot because the people, those who specialize in a particular field, if they come and talk to the children, they cover the topic better. And at the same time, the teachers of the school and others in school are always available to them. And they can ask questions, but then somebody coming from outside, and especially with so much of coverage of the same event where the children also get attracted towards that, I think it is something very good.
These carriers of change are hopeful of making a difference towards creating a Behtar India.
I've learned a lot from this presentation and more which I've learned is that how I can prevent dengue and how I can curb this from the society. And I have also learned that what are the symptoms that cause dengue and hence I'll surely help to create awareness about this in the society.
Mumbai has been seeing a steep rise in the number of dengue cases over the past few years. While the city corporation has a plan in place to fight it, let's go across to my colleague Saurabh to understand what makes Mumbai more prone to dengue outbreaks.
From the national capital to the financial capital, every monsoon is a challenge for the Brihanmumbai Municipal Corporation or the BMC, and every challenge has to be tackled. The battle against vector-borne diseases has to be taken to every doorstep in this crowded, bustling city.
BMC officers have a mammoth task, and every home is being checked for possible breeding grounds for mosquitoes. Stagnant water, they say, is checked, and if any breeding is found, they take immediate action. In a city with a huge population that depends on stored water instead of running water, the challenge is even bigger.
We start this campaign for monsoon preparation right from February, March. And prior to monsoon, we remove all such odd articles on rooftops of slums and all. The second important thing in the urban millennial strategy is engineering measures where you cannot remove the sources. Those sources should be mosquito-proof.
The eggs may actually hatch up to a couple of years after they have been laid by the 80s. You know, so simply to say that the monsoon this year is over and that the hatching of the eggs may not happen again, that's not quite the way it functions. So you might find that eggs will hatch next year or the year after. So it's not enough to say that the garbage has come out of your house, you've dumped it outside, and that is the end of the problem as far as you're concerned. You know, there are housing societies that take lots of steps in making sure that dry and wet garbage is disposed of as it should be, so that it's not going to be in a place where there's going to be more breeding.
After searching through every home, BMC officials find a spot where dengue mosquitoes are breeding. Corrective action must be immediate, or else it could result in an outbreak of dengue in these parts of the city.
Samples are collected and residents are asked to drain out the water immediately. Insecticide sprayed, residents asked to conduct tests if they report fever. The BMC maintains after all of this, they also fall back on the tried and tested method of fogging. And while they've managed to control malaria, dengue still remains a challenge due to lack of public participation in spite of several campaigns.
Dengue is the problem of all urban cities. Every year there is a marginal increase in the number of cases and deaths. So that's why the focus nowadays is on dengue. Because the mosquito is domestic and peridomestic, as I explained, it bites during daytime. Its eggs can survive for 1 year.
Fogging remains one of the most effective methods to tackle the spread of vector-borne diseases, but the BMC realizes fogging alone won't do the job, which is why several other methods have been put in place, along with fogging, to tackle the menace of vector-borne diseases.